Random House Audio presents The Third Jesus, The Christ We Cannot Ignore by Deepak Chopra. This is the author, Deepak Chopra. Jesus Christ left behind a riddle that 2,000 years of worship hasn't solved. The riddle can be stated in one sentence. Why are Jesus' teachings impossible to live by? It would startle millions of Christians to hear that this riddle exists. They try to live by Jesus' words every day. They love, pray, show compassion, and practice charity in His name. Yet these humane and worthy actions, which reveal a good heart intent on serving God, do not fulfill Jesus' deeper mandate. What Jesus actually taught is much more radical and at the same time mystical. When I was a child in India, I first heard about the Golden Rule from the Christian brothers who had traveled from Ireland to run our school. This basic tenet of Christianity, which comes from the book of Matthew, is simple enough to teach even to small children. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So where is the riddle? What could possibly be considered radical or mystical here? Actually, it's wildly radical to ask yourself to live by the Golden Rule. Taken literally, it requires you to treat an enemy as an equal, which means in essence that you can have no enemies. It calls upon a country not to wage war or defend itself if attacked. It demands complete empathy for criminals and evildoers. Jesus didn't say, pick the easiest people and treat them nicely, just as you'd like to be treated. That might be the gilded rule, which is what the Golden Rule became, once people realized that Jesus' teaching couldn't be reconciled with human nature. It's human nature to love those who love us in return, not those who hate us. It's human nature to fight back when attacked. This violates another basic but impossible tenet of Jesus's, resist not evil. But Jesus makes no such allowances. Taken literally, many of Jesus's most famous words defy human nature in this way. Turn the other cheek. Love thy neighbor as thyself. But what if my neighbor and I are arguing over a two-story addition to my house that blocks his view of the ocean? Under those circumstances, my neighbor and I have opposing interests, so how can I love him as I love myself? When my neighbor's grandchild comes over to play with mine, I may be fond of his grandchild, but I can't love him with the same devotion and selflessness that I love my own, can I? If Jesus' words are too radical to live by, was that his intention? Or have we misunderstood a spiritual teacher who seems to be so clear, simple, and direct? I propose that both have occurred. Jesus intended a completely new view of human nature, and unless you transform yourself, you misunderstand what he had to say. You can struggle your entire life to be a good Christian without succeeding in doing what Jesus explicitly wanted. He wanted to inspire a world reborn in God. This vision is breathtaking in its ambition. It points us toward a mystical realm, the only place where human nature can radically change. At the level of the soul, we find out how to love our neighbors as ourselves. We are able to remove the obstacles that keep us from doing unto others as we would want them to do unto us. Jesus' name for the realm of the soul is the kingdom of God, and he clearly intended for it to descend to earth. On earth, let it be as it is in heaven. God was to replace Caesar as the ruler of human affairs, and all the conditions that applied to material existence would change. Jesus could not have been more direct when he said that total transformation was near. In fact, this was perhaps the first and most important message he wanted to deliver. From the time Jesus began to preach, he said, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Yet Jesus failed to bring about God's rule on earth, and his radical vision became compromised only a generation after his death, at the same time that early Christianity was spreading with startling speed and intensity. The disciples who had followed him knew without a doubt that they had met someone of earth-shaking significance. What the disciples didn't talk about so fervently was the shadow side of their new faith. They were struggling to live as Jesus wanted them to, and in many respects, they were failing. They fought for power among themselves and squabbled over doctrine. They had doubts and fears of persecution. Jealousy and sexual desire made their age-old claims. Such basic matters as whether to follow Peter or Paul as chief spokesman for Jesus drove Christians apart. The early church was rife with disputes and conflicts, just like every other faith that had come before. To emerge from this chaos, to survive as followers of the Messiah, was a life-and-death challenge. As a result, Christianity was forced to compromise Jesus' vision. The alternative, a complete transformation of human nature, was proving impossible. Those few who could achieve it became known as saints, and they were far removed from the dirty, bustling world and its corrupt ways. In this audiobook, I argue that Jesus' vision isn't impossible to realize. Yes, it is radical and mystical. None of that has changed, but the underlying dilemma, how to live as Jesus wanted us to, can be resolved. In fact, it must be resolved if Jesus is to have any kind of meaningful future. In order to find the answer to the Jesus riddle, we must begin with radical surgery, cutting through the time-worn Jesus that all of us know, even those like me who were not raised in the church. That traditional version of Jesus was constructed as a compromise. It accepts the essential failure of Christ's vision, so we must go beyond it. The Jesus we all know comes in two guises: the historical Jesus, who was a man of flesh and blood, and the theological Jesus, a person who never lived but took shape through a gradual, long-term build-up of dogma and doctrine. Behind these constructs stands a third Jesus, the radical teacher who taught his followers how to change the world. The third Jesus inhabited a higher state of consciousness. He was already in the kingdom of God. It was as familiar to him as breathing and just as central to his being. The intimacy between God and Jesus was total at the level of consciousness. There is no other place where it could be so complete, because contrary to Christian law, Jesus did not physically descend from God's dwelling place above the clouds, nor did he return to sit at the right hand of a literal throne. What made Jesus the Son of God was the fact that he had achieved God consciousness. Jesus said as much over and over when he declared that the Father and I are one. He knew no separation between his thoughts and God's thoughts, his feelings and God's feelings, his actions and the actions God wanted performed. I realize that I'm quoting the most basic of Jesus' words, but we have no choice but to start at the beginning. Radical comes from the Latin word radix, or root. Jesus, the radical, went to the root of the human condition, and his approach to suffering was to eradicate it, literally to tear it out by the root. In that spirit, I've tried to tell the truly important story about Jesus, which is the story not of his life, or even of his words, but of the mind that created both. From the outset, I assumed that Jesus belongs to the world and not to one faith. Many confirmed Christians will not agree. They will demand to know how an outsider can presume to explain Christ to those who are already Christian. In the first place, I revere Jesus as someone who included anyone who wished to follow him. His mission was to open the gates to the kingdom of heaven, not to close them. He knew only too well the pain of being cast out by Jerusalem's temple priests. Jesus' brief ministry was haunted by threats of official persecution that eventually became reality. But my attachment to Jesus is more personal too. It dates from my childhood, when I heard Christian prayers at the Catholic school I attended and Vedic chants at home. I was encouraged to respect every...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.